upstairs, right? And there was this girl, Michelle her name was, right? And she's whipped out this credit card, right? And she stuck it over my chest, over the wound to stop the bleeding. Can you believe it? She's fucking holding me together with a fucking credit card, right? It's just... yeah, it was mental, mate. It was... they took the veins out of me leg. Look at that, look, I've got a car up there. Shit. They took it out of me leg, right, and they fed it down me arm, right, me veins. And I sort of wake up and I've got all the machines round me, beep, beep, I've got fucking wires coming out me arse and everything, and,
lovely.
My mum was sitting there. Yeah, like, right at the end of me bed, just looking at me. Last time I saw her, actually. I think to myself, though, why do I have that last line? Do you know what I mean? Why did I have that last line? And I think, yeah, all right, mate, yes. You've made your fucking point with that. Do you know what I mean? Why do you have to fucking stab me four times in me back for, eh? I mean, you're trying to fucking kill me, ain't he? What's all that about?
Be a fucking shit story, though, wouldn't it?
It's true, mate, yeah.
Nice one, mate.
Yeah.
Stood up. It's so blue, it's amazing.
Jesus.
Wow. A little Beckham head. Oh, she's a sweetheart. Smell her, babe, so. Do you know what I mean? That's yeah. What does it.
She could pull that off.
I know. Mm-hmm. Just that just brings it all back. It's just like, gutted me a bit today.
Oh, Jesus, come here.
Oh, I never thought. You look lovely together.
No, who should be Boston?
Yeah, no, right, they're safe, they're in Canada.
Jake's 11.
Jesus, 11. Skinny. Adam.
Does he look like you?
Yeah, he looks
Adam.
Mad.
Adam, come on.
Which did you miss one?
Rosie, believe it. Sorry. Rosie, can I have a quick word?
Come on, Dean, it's song of the day. Come on, it's your choice, song of the day.
Need you to keep an eye on Lydia for me.
Oh, come on. No, I'm not.
Come on, Rosie, you can deal with a bit of extra responsibility.
Oh, come on, Sam, this a bit.
Rosie, you know alcohol is the worst withdrawal. She's going to need someone.
The ones that are hardest to get off the ground.
I can identify with that.
Why do you do what you do?
Because that place is life. Working there gives me a chance to put something back into it. When you're a resident, you're always scared that the culture will collapse. And I suppose that never leaves you. But I got to stay detached. I can't afford to be too personally involved. I mean, I get angry. I get really angry. I mean, think about it, in 9 months, people come in off the street and in that time they're supposed to sort everything out. They're supposed to kick a habit. They're supposed to deal, they've got to deal with what made them, or get real with what made them junkie in the first place. They've got to sort everything out internally, externally, come up the whirlpool, get a flat, get a job. In 9 months, I mean, limited resources, you think about it. I'm just ranting away here, I'm ranting about it, aren't I?
Uh-uh.
I'm ranting.
No. I'm really interested, actually. It's exactly the conversation I've wanted to have with someone. I've had a lot of conversations, Tommy, and most of them have been talking heads, babbling on about statistics. I've had very few conversations with people about the actual process. Tommy, how would you feel about me coming to film at the Ashton? You don't like that idea.
I'm weary. I know there's a number of things, Susie. It's... what about your relationship with Danny?
Well, I don't actually think it's about my relationship with Danny. I think Danny's in your capable hands now, isn't he?
It's about the fact that I'm really interested in what you're doing, and I'd really like to show it to people.
Let's talk about it, eh?
Okay.